Good morning, students. Welcome to Adarsh Vidyalaya Education Online Class. Children, in the last session, we have studied about sexual reproduction in flowering plants. In that, we learned about structure of a typical flower, structure of pollen grain, structure of ovule, and the process of pollination. In this session, we are going to study about the process of fertilization. Before entering into the topic, let's see a quick recap of the last part, the structure of pollen grain and the structure of ovule, because the two are related with this process of fertilization. When we see the structure of pollen grain, it is spherical in shape. It is surrounded by two membranes. The outer membrane is thick, hard membrane called exine. It has minute pore called germ pore. Inner membrane is intine. It is thin membrane and it is made up of pectin and cellulose. The pollen grains contains two cells, vegetative cell and generative cell. The vegetative cell contains the vegetative nucleus, which is large in size. The generative cell divides mitotically and produce two male gametes. Then when we see the structure of ovule, ovule is present inside the ovary. The nucellus is the main part of the ovule. The nucellus is surrounded by two layered membrane called integuments. This integument leaves a minute opening at the base called micropyle. Inside the nucellus, embryo sac is there. The embryo sac contains 7 cells and 8 nuclei. 3 cells towards the chalazolite, 3 cells towards the micropyle end, 1 cell at the middle called central cell. The 3 cells which is towards the chalazolite is called as antipodal cells. The remaining 3 cells, which is present at the micropylar end, at the middle female gamete, on either side of the female gamete, synergids are there. Then at the middle one cell is there. That cell is called a central cell or polar nuclei or secondary nucleus. In that central cell contains 2 nuclei, which is diploid in nature. That's all about ovule and the pollen grain. Now, come to the topic, fertilization. In sexual reproduction of plants has two processes. The first process is pollination. The second process is fertilization. Pollination, we have learned in the previous session. What is pollination? Transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma of a flower, in which two types of pollination, self-pollination, cross-pollination. The pollination is followed by fertilization. What is fertilization? Fertilization is the process of the fusion of male and female gamete. As a result of fusion of male gamete sperm with a female gamete, here forms zygote. This process is called fertilization. Now let's see how the fertilization process takes place in plants. Now you look at the diagram. As the pollen grains falls on the suitable stigma, it starts to germinate. Germinate in the sense, we know pollen grains has two cells, vegetative cell and a generative cell. Now the vegetative cell forms a tube-like structure called pollen tube. This pollen tube emerges out from the pollen grain through the germ pore present in it. So, as the pollen grain falls on the suitable stigma, the vegetative cell of the pollen grains forms a pollen tube which emerges out through the germ pore and passes through this style. The generative cell gets into the tube and divides into two male gametes. This pollen tube now passes through the style region. Gradually, little by little, it grows and now it reaches the ovule. As it enters into the embryo sac, the pollen tube bursts open and releases the two male gametes into the embryo sac. One of the male gametes fuses with the female gamete and forms zygote. This process is called syngamy. The second male gamete fuses with the secondary nucleus, which is present at the central cell, and form triploid endosperm nucleus. This fusion is called tuple fusion. Why it is called as tuple fusion? We know the central cell has two nuclei that is diploid in nature. So that two nuclei is now fused with the second male gamete. So the second male gamete have haploid set of chromosome. That secondary nucleus have diploid chromosome. So now triploid cell is formed. So two fertilization takes place within the embryo sac. One male gamete fuses with the female gamete, forms zygote. This process is called syngamy. The second male gamete fuses with the secondary nucleus and form primary endosperm nucleus. This fusion is called tuple fusion. This primary endosperm nucleus is developed into endosperm, which is made for the development of embryo. This endosperm provides nutritive tissue for the developing embryo. Since two fertilization takes place inside the ovary, this process is called double fertilization. What happens after the fertilization? After the fertilization process gets over, the ovary develops into fruit. The ovule develops into seed. The integument of the ovule develops into seed coat. The seed coat carries the embryo, which develops into the seedling when it falls on the suitable substratum. Now, let's study the next topic, sexual reproduction in human. So far, we learned about how the reproduction process takes place in plants. The first session we studied two types of reproduction found in plants, that is vegetative reproduction and asexual reproduction. The second session we studied about the sexual reproduction in plants. Now let's study about how the sexual reproduction takes place in human beings. We all will know we are the higher organisms. We are the superior animals in the animal kingdom. We have well developed organs. So the male has the male reproductive system. The female has the female reproductive system. The male reproductive system produces the male gamete sperm. Female reproductive system produces the female gamete, ova or egg. First, the reproductive system in human are divided into two types. Primary reproductive organs, accessory reproductive organs. Primary reproductive organs are gonads. Gonads means testes in males, ovaries in females. This testes in males and the ovaries in females. These two are called as gonads. They are called as the primary sex organs. The reason is these gonads are directly involved in the process of reproduction by producing gametes as well as by producing the sex hormones. The testes producing the male gamete sperm as well as the male sex hormone testosterone. The ovary produces the female gamete ova or egg as well as it produces the female sex hormones estrogen and progesterone. That's why these testes and ovaries are called as primary sex organs. The rest of the organs present in the male reproductive system as well as in the female reproductive system are called as accessory organs. Let's see what are the accessory organs are present in male reproductive system. In male reproductive system, vas deferens, epididymis, seminal vesicle, prostate gland and penis. These organs are called as accessory organs, as these organs not directly involved in the production of reproduction. They are supporting the reproductive process. In females, fallopian tubes, we know in the female reproductive system has a pair of ovaries. From each ovary a tube is arising, that is called as fallopian tube or oviduct. These two oviducts are joints in a sac-like structure called uterus. This fallopian tube, uterus, that uterus there, followed by cervix, then it's followed by vagina, that is also called as birth canal. So this fallopian tube, uterus, cervix, vagina, these organs in female are called as accessory organs. Now let's see what are the functions performed by these accessory organs. We well know what are the role performed by the primary sex organs, that is the testes and ovary. I told you they are producing gametes as well as they are involved in the production of hormones, sex hormones. But in these accessory organs are involved in the process of ovulation. In female, ovulation process takes place. Ovulation means the release of matured ovum from the ovary. So these accessory organs involved in the process of ovulation, then the process of fertilization, the fusion of male gamete sperm with the female gamete ova is called fertilization. The fertilization takes place in the fallopian tube. Then the accessory organs involved in the division of zygote. We know after the formation of zygote, the zygote undergone mitotic division and develops into embryo. Then these organs involved in pregnancy, the child, that fetus is implanted at the endometrium of the uterus for 280 days. So the accessory organs are involved in the process of pregnancy as well as the development of the fetus, childbirth process. Now let's see once again what are the functions of accessory organs. It involves in the process of ovulation, in the process of fertilization, division of zygote and the development of embryo, pregnancy process, development of the fetus as well as childbirth process. Now let's see the male reproductive organ, testes. Structure of testes. As you can see on the screen, this is the structure of testes. The testes are oval in shape. A pair of testes are located outside the abdominal cavity in males. It is located outside the abdominal cavity and it is covered by a sac-like structure called scrotal sac. The reason is the formation of sperms needs lower temperature than the normal body temperature. That is why our normal body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius or 98.4 degree Fahrenheit to 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. But the sperm formation is lesser than this temperature. That's why the testis is located outside the abdominal cavity in males. It is oval in shape. Let's see the structure. When we see the cross section of the testis is surrounded by a fibrous tissue, a tough fibrous tissue that is called as tunica albuginea. Tunica albuginea. This tunica albuginea forms many invagination inside the testis and forms many septa. So that inside the testis forms many pyramidal lobules. You can see these are the pyramidal lobules. Many seminiferous tubules are present inside these pyramidal lobules. These seminiferous tubules are responsible for the formation of sperm. In between this seminiferous tubule, there are one type of cell that is called as Leydig cell or interstitial cells. These Leydig cells or interstitial cells are involved in the secretion of male sex hormone testosterone. Along with this Leydig cell, another one cells are there that they are called as Sertoli cells. These Sertoli cells are supporting cells. They are nourishing the developing sperms. So, this is the structure of testes. This is oval in shape. It is located outside the abdominal cavity. The reason is sperm formation needs lesser temperature than the normal body temperature. The testes are surrounded by the fibrous connective tissue that is called as tunica albuginea. This tunica albuginea forms many invaginations or foldings inside the testes and forms many pyramidal lobules or many septa inside the testes. Each septa contains numerous seminiferous tubules. In between the seminiferous tubule, Leydig cells are there. These Leydig cells are also called as interstitial cells. That is responsible for the production of male gamete testosterone. Then one more cells are there, Sertoli cells. They are the supporting cells. They are nourishing the developing sperms. Now let's study the structure of ovary. As you see on the screen, the ovary is almond shape. It is located, a pair of ovaries are located on either side of the lower abdomen in human female. When we see the cross section of ovary, the outer portion is called as cortex, inner portion is called medulla. The outer cortex is surrounded by network of fibrous tissue structures called as stroma. This stroma further surrounded by single layer of germinal epithelial cells. Inside, inner part of the ovary is called medulla. this medullary part, you would see the follicles of different stages. These follicles only becomes like gradually grows and forms ovum. That means the primordial follicles grows in the enlarges into primary follicles. These primary follicles further enlarges into secondary follicles. The secondary follicles develops into Grafian follicles. Inside the Grafian follicle, mature ovum is there. By the process of ovulation, that mature ovum is releases out from the ovary. So, the medulla is the inner part of the ovary. Here, each ovum is surrounded by the germinal epithelial cells called granulosa cells. So, the granulosa cells with the ovum is called as Grafian follicle. So far we studied the structure of testes and ovary. Now let's see the process of gametogenesis. Gametogenesis means gamete formation. The formation of sperm in males, testes of males, and ova in ovaries of female is called gametogenesis. The formation of sperm in male are called spermatogenesis. Ova in female is called oogenesis. Now let's see the structure of male gamete sperm. This is the structure of human sperm. It consists of four parts: head, neck, middle piece and tail. The head, it is an elongated composed of nucleus. The tip of the head is covered by a cap-like structure called acrosome. It contains an enzyme called hyaluronidase. This hyaluronidase enzyme helps the sperm to penetrate ova at the time of fertilization. The next, a small neck is there. This neck connects the headpiece with the tail. The next, middle piece. This middle piece is composed of mitochondria. As we know, mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell. It provides energy for the motility of sperm during fertilization. The next last part is tail. This tail helps to motility to move in the liquid semen to reach the ovum. Now let's see the structure of ovum. This is the structure of ovum. It is spherical in shape. The human ovum is free of yolk. It contains abundant of cytoplasm and a nucleus. This ovum is surrounded by three membranes. The outermost membrane is called as corona radiata, middle plasma membrane, inner membrane is called zona pellucida. Then the ovum, the surface of ovum is also surrounded by one membrane that is called as vitelline membrane. There is a fluid filled space in between the vitelline membrane and the zona pellucida is called as perivitelline space. Let's see a quick recap of this gamete. The male gamete sperm, it has four parts: head, neck, middle piece, tail. The head is elongated, composed of nucleus. The tip of the head contains a small cap-like structure, acrosome. This acrosome contains an enzyme, hyaluronidase. This enzyme helps the sperms to penetrate ova at the time of fertilization. Then short neck is there. It is composed of centrioles. It connects the head with the tail or the middle piece. The next is middle piece. It is composed of mitochondria. This mitochondria provides energy for motility. Then tail piece. This tail piece also helps to move the sperm towards the ova during fertilization. Now when we see the structure of ova, it is spherical in shape. The human ova is free of yolk then abundant of cytoplasm and the nucleus is there. The ovum is surrounded by three membranes. The outermost membrane is corona radiata, middle membrane plasma membrane, inner membrane zona pellucida. Then the ovum, that is inside this part is ovum. This ovum is the surface of ovum is covered by vitelline membrane. There is a space present in between this vitelline membrane and the zona pellucida is called as perivitelline space. Okay, children. So in today's session, we have learned about the fertilization process in plants, then sexual reproduction in human. Under that, we studied about the structure of testes, structure of ovary, gametogenesis process, structure of male gamete sperm and the female gamete ova. Thank you.